amazing feeling of freedom. I saw that I was bigger than what I do. I was bigger than my body. I was everything and everyone.
Where one is able to understand that this body is simply a garment, just as we change clothes from day to day, that the body is simply being used by the soul.
And as I looked ahead, there was this pure white light. It was whiter than the whitest snow and brighter than 10,000 suns ahead. You looked right at it and it was compelling, it was compelling.
The human heart is now documented as the strongest generator of both electrical and magnetic fields in the body. Now this is important because we've always been taught that the brain is where the action is. The brain has an electrical field, it does have a magnetic field, but they're relatively weak compared to the heart. The heart is about 100 times stronger electrically and up to 5,000 times stronger, 5,000 times stronger magnetically than the brain. And the reason this is important is because the physical world as we know it is made of those two fields of energy, electrical and magnetic fields of energy, electromagnetic fields. Our own physics books now tell us if we can change either the magnetic field of an atom or the electrical field of the atom, by doing that we literally change that atom. We change the stuff that our bodies in this world are made of. And it appears now that the human heart is designed to do both, to change both the electrical field and the magnetic field of our bodies and our world, and they do so in response to the emotions that we create between our heart and our brain.
Hallelujah. there are 300,000 manuscripts and books on peace. Each of these books and manuscripts have been read by an average 3 people, including the author and the publisher. Who wants to read another book, you know, about peace? We want to create peace. There's an actual science of peace. Because the field of consciousness is the field of unity, field of bliss, field of peace. On a tangible, palpable, powerful, physical level, millions of times more powerful than the nuclear force, if we can just access it. But consciousness can access it. What we need are more peacemakers who develop their nervous systems to the point where they become lighthouses of peace, radiating peace. Peace.
But when it comes to a tsunami or shift in the tectonic plates, if you really believe in consciousness, even that, you would say, has a connection to turbulence in the collective mind, because we are part of nature, right? You are part of nature. You're not outside of nature. So if the collective mind is turbulent, nature is turbulent. We tend to separate ourselves from nature, but we're not. You know, if we settle down, maybe nature will settle down.
Over the past 18 years, our research center has investigated heart-brain interactions, how the heart and the brain communicate with each other and how that affects consciousness and our perceptions. One of the things we identified in our research was the state we now call coherence. And what we found was that when we're feeling positive emotions, like we're really appreciating the sunset, or really feeling love or compassion or care for someone, that the heart beats out a very different message. The heart generates by far the largest rhythmic electromagnetic field produced in the body. And what we've now found is that if we look at the spectrum analysis of the magnetic field radiated by the heart, that emotional information is actually encoded and modulating into those fields. So by learning to shift our emotions, that's changing the information we're encoding into the magnetic fields radiated by the heart, and that can impact those around us. We are fundamentally and deeply interconnected with each other and the planet itself. And what we do individually really does count and matters.
but resurrected in a way by one man who says he has discovered behind me here not only the first pyramid on the entire European continent, but the largest, biggest valley of pyramids in the entire world.
In only a few months of excavation, plenty of stonework has already been discovered. Samir used satellite, thermal, and topography analysis on tens of thousands of hills in his search for pyramids.
Instead of thousands of hills, we found nine of them, five of them being located in this valley. You have perfect geometry and you have cardinal points. Once I saw that a year and a half ago, I immediately knew that this is not a naturally made hill, but man-made.
Archaeologists are making a fascinating discovery. Let's go to see that's Brooke Baldwin. She traveled to Mirador and came back with an amazing story. Brooke, tell our viewers what's going on.
Wolf, I think I'm officially an archaeology geek. Our CNN crew, we're the first TV camera actually in the world to shoot the face of what may be the world's largest pyramid by volume. This pyramid, it is covered by the canopy of the jungle. It is currently facing several threats. From the air, it looks like just jungle, but these forests in Guatemala hide an ancient secret. The city of Mirador, often referred to as the cradle of Mayan civilization, the size of a modern-day metropolis. This is no mountain. It's a pyramid, and according to the Mirador Basin Project, it may be the largest pyramid by volume in the world.
At the very end of the Japanese archipelago lies Yonaguni, shrouded in mist and mystery.
Several meters beneath the surface lies one of the world's greatest mysteries, a place that could, quite literally, rewrite human history. No one can be entirely sure what's down there, but many experts are convinced it's the remains of a vast and ancient underwater city, a lost civilization, a Japanese Atlantis.
Thank you. beginning. And we look for a glorious denouement when we will discover that we are actually members of one family.
The hand can make our planet a more peaceful, healthy, and equitable place to live.
The path of forgiveness instead of revenge, the path of reconciliation instead of retribution.
I believe that in the earth, it is kindness and generous accommodation that are the catalyst for real change.
That which you give your energy and your emotion to becomes your reality. It is every human's gift. Whatever you give your emotion to becomes reality for you.